The stem is flexible. It's impossible to break. But occasionally on the same plant, there's a bloom whose stem is not so flexible. Ah, here's one. See? And when the stem is brittle, it breaks.
You're saying that the Maquis crew is rigid and inflexible, that they will never adjust to Starfleet rules.
No, Mr. Vulcan. I'm saying that you are rigid and inflexible. But maybe if you'd learn to bend a little, you might have better luck with your class. Those Maquis aren't Starfleet cadets. You can't treat them the same way. Get to know them. Huh? Try to find out what they're like inside. You might discover a better teaching method.
I am not sure if I have the ability to find out what they're like inside. Mr. Neelix, what is that?
Oof, grilled cheese. I made it from that schlicht we brought on board last week. Ensign Ashmore asked for something called macaroni and cheese.
Cheese. You must cultivate bacteria to make cheese.
Of course.
Captain's log, stardate 48859.3. Lieutenant Tuvok has reported what may be a possible explanation for the infection in the bio-neural gel packs. I have asked Lieutenant Torres and her team to investigate Neelix's kitchen.
Get me a schematic of the airflow patterns for the whole ship.
Aye, sir.
The cheese is full of volatile bacterial spores. It has to stay isolated in this portable containment field.
What is this?
That's just a Lorelian pudding. It has to simmer for 4 hours.
The spores must have traveled through that intake and then into the ventilation system.
Where they were disseminated throughout the ship, subsequently infecting the bioneural circuitry.
I feel awful about this. I assure you, I had no idea.
More gel packs must be down. If this is getting to the environmental systems, we may be in more trouble than we thought. Neelix, this wasn't your fault. The important thing is that we found the source. Get the cheese to sickbay. The doctor should look at it as soon as possible.
Yes, Lieutenant.